Yeah.
What's up, vegan adventurers? Welcome to another exciting walk. And today we're gonna be camping with sea lions on El Chino Beach in Galapagos on San Cristobal Island. So this is the first time camping in South America. So we're a little bit nervous and really excited, but I'm sure it will be amazing. So let's get into this walk. Chino Beach. Our taxi took us here and we had to get some diesel for cooking. So it was funny. And now we're gonna walk 15 minutes and hopefully without any issues we can set up a camp. So we just arrived to El Chino Beach. There's a sea lion sleeping on the table. Our camping table. This should be an area for camping somewhere here, but not sure exactly where. I have to find a guide. So it is allowed to camp on Galapagos, but only on designated campsite, and El Chino Beach is one of them. First thing you need to do is to go to the national park office and announce like 2 days before that you're gonna camp, and then you have to pay like $20 a night. So it's 12 o'clock and this is our campsite. We're gonna set up a tent by the beach. So this is too rough here. You could camp here, but it's a bit down the hill. And here is the seating table, and all these birds are just waiting for some food. I think they're used to that people are cooking here. Well, yeah, so we're gonna set up a tent now and then eat the lunch. So we just set up the base of the tent. I think we got a pretty good location. Alright, the tent is set up. And now we're just gonna put our mattresses there, sleeping bags, and that's it. So it's also possible to camp on other designated areas, like on Santa Cruz there is one beach, and on San Cristobal there's a few more beaches, and I'm not sure about Isabella Island. So for lunch we had potatoes that we cooked the night before, and also a vegan burger that Tanya made from lentils. And there are these fearless birds all the time trying to get to our food. This is the Galapagos life. You're not scared at all here, there are no predators. So as soon as we started eating, there are so many birds around, really close to you, and one of them pooped on my hair. So it's pretty funny, but annoying at the same time. Sea lions, and our tent is just here.
another sea lions over here.
Recording the sea lions, we went for a little walk up to the viewpoint, which takes only a few minutes. Mirador Puerto Chino. I want you to feel at home here. Your help is crucial to keep this visit site as natural as possible. You will see a great diversity of birds, including land and mangrove lynxes, mana canaries, mockingbirds, frigate birds, blue-footed boobies and pelicans. Species are very important to this fragile ecosystem. Then we saw this lonely sea lion pretty far away from the beach and quite high, and I think it was a result of a fight with another male. Then we got to the end of this viewpoint, and there we spotted another blue-footed booby. This time was sleeping on the rock. So then we decided to go a little bit more to explore the coastline, but we just went for a few minutes. My stay. So after we returned back to the beach, there was another path going under the cliffs, so we decided to check it out. So after just few meters going under the cliff, we discovered this little cave, but it was not going very far. And after a few more meters, we got till the end of the path, and it was straight under that viewpoint we were taking pictures, and there was another little cave. So as we had nothing else to do, I decided to do some bouldering or climbing on the cliffs without rope. So it's pretty exciting, but you have to know what you're doing and never push over your limits where you feel too frightened and too stressed about the route. So if you feel comfortable climbing some route without rope, that's when you should do it. But when you feel too uncomfortable, don't attempt to try it because you might end up hurting yourself. After climbing, we were kind of hot, so we decided to jump in the sea, and we were hoping to see more creatures, but I took some good GoPro footage. Enjoy it. Our campsite again and Lobos. It says even here that it's camping area. This site has been assigned for you, so it is your responsibility to keep it clear of litter. Please collaborate on conserving this site for future visitors as well. Thank you very much. So officially you can camp here, guys. So after we went for a little snorkeling, but there was nothing to see, so I didn't record anything. And then I went to do some bouldering again, and it's pretty exciting and it's a great sense of accomplishment. But as I said, you have to be really careful and only do things which you feel comfortable with. So here I am doing the same thing, but this time with a different route. And every time I make sure that the hold is really good and that I have at least three good points. So yeah, as I said, start with the simpler routes and then work towards more complicated.
I did it! Good job.
Hey guys, so we're just having dinner, finishing the potatoes. We're cooking here some pasta.
This MSR Dragonfly.
It's a pretty good stove. It runs on diesel, unleaded auto fuel, and also a white gas or naphtha. The priming was pretty bad today. I'm not sure if I put too much, it was all on fire. But once it's done priming, it's pretty good. And it's boiling good, yeah. So we're just on the beach here. And here we have the beach with the sea lions. Hope we didn't come all the way to our tent. Some of them are swimming, some of them are laying down here. It's all good. We have like half an hour of sunset, of sunrise, and sunlight, and then we go sleep.
Hello, baby.
Morning, so it's 8:30 Galapagos time, and here are the sea lions again, but they went out into the sea at around darkness, 6 p.m. and then they didn't come back until like early morning, maybe 4 a.m. or something like that. I think actually one was here the whole night, but the rest of them were out in the sea the whole time, so that's why they're all sleeping now, because they were pretty much out there fishing, or I don't know what. We have to read about them more. So we didn't see any sea lions until now, and now we're gonna have breakfast.
Okay, how was the night?
Yeah, Sonia got scared, as always. I was not scared, but yeah, I was sleeping good. It's just you need to get used to it, you know, when you don't sleep often in a tent.
Yeah, it was pretty comfortable, you know,
but we didn't take enough water, so a little bit dehydrated. Should have taken more water always. That's one thing, like always take more water than food when you go
when you go somewhere where there, you know, there is no water. So yeah, we're gonna have breakfast now and we'll see what's next. Probably go more snorkeling or something.
What are you doing?
We are having breakfast now. I have some oranges left and Sanya made snake and tongue.
There is a banana, pear, apple, cinnamon, and brown sugar, and cereal.
And here we are going to do some more bouldering, as we have more time before our taxi arrives at 2 p.m. Here is Sanya trying out the wall for the first time. After many tries, Sanya finally made it up. And remember, never push over your limit so much that you feel frightened and scared. Here at the end, I'm looking for a perfect hold to hold me good, because if your hold is slippery, then it's really dangerous if you're climbing without rope. And here we spotted the blue-footed booby again. This time it was not sleeping. So you can see the blue feet, but this one doesn't have a really like a deep color blue, and it depends on how much blue fish they eat or blue seafood. So this one apparently was not eating so much blue seafood as the other blue-footed boobies. Okay, it's 1:52 and we're just leaving the Chino beach with the sea lions. It was great to camp here. Definitely good adventure waking up with the sea lions. And now we're gonna go to get our taxi. He should come in 8 minutes at 2 o'clock, so hopefully he will come. We maybe paid him already, so he has to come. And yeah, it was good, but we didn't have enough water with us, so we had to cook with the salt water at the end, the pasta. But otherwise it was great. Also the climbing, over there on the boulder. Sea lion is back on the table. Bye bye, sea lion. We'll see Chino next time with some, hopefully with some of you guys who are interested in healthy vegan adventures and doing this kind of crazy stuff. It's not that crazy, but we're just gonna show you how it's done properly. Because first we go to try the waters, and then with you we know exactly what to do. So there are a few things that we did wrong, like I cooked too many potatoes, so we didn't finish the potatoes for lunch, and then we didn't even finish them for dinner, and then they went bad the next day. So we brought too much food with us and not enough water. So when are you camping on a beach when there is no water source, just bring more water, and you know, you don't need as many calories for this day. So we had to learn the hard way. But water is one of the things that you need a lot all the time. But food, you can live on fewer calories on some days. And what did you learn from this trip?
That the sea lions go somewhere at night.
Yeah, the sea lions going somewhere at night. I think they're going hunt for fish or something. But they come back in the morning, like it's 3 or 4 in the morning. So we didn't hear them at all night until the morning, which was good because we could sleep more. Okay. So we are back in a taxi, and you can see how the weather changed. Just a few hundred meters up the hill, and you have a fog and a little rain, and the vegetation changed as well. So you can see, even on the little island like this, you can experience different microclimates, which is amazing. So we are back in San Cristobal town, and Sanya had to climb on this big sea lion statue. So you can see that the sea lions really like to go anywhere, on the benches, on the street. So it's really a special place to be, to observe the sea lions.
He attacked her pup.
Who?
And I read also that when there's scarce of food, they eat the pups.
Really?
Not because they're hungry, but because it's like a protection. Uh-huh. Like they know they're not gonna survive, and they're trying to cut down the population.
Really?
And the big ones will eat the pup.
Really?
Like when there's no fish. Or I'm not sure if you understand. I know that dogs do that. They know it. They have to feed them all the dog thing.
So thank you very much, guys, for watching this exciting first camping in South America. And I also hope you enjoy seeing the sea lions, because tomorrow is our last day on San Cristobal, and then we're gonna travel to last island, Isabella Island, where we're gonna see more animals. So for now, stay healthy and stay adventurous.